GRIS, the Global Register of Introduced and Invasive Species, was conceptualized over a decade ago. It was developed by the IUCN, the Invasive Species Specialist Group, based here at the University of Auckland. And the reasons at that time were for us to get a picture of how many invasive species were there exactly across the world, and to also understand the extent of the threat of biological invasions. But since the decade has passed, and today I think the GRIS, the tool itself, has more relevance. The relevance has shifted slightly. Biological invasions are recognized as one of the key drivers of biodiversity loss. And the Convention on Biological Diversity in its meeting has articulated about 20 targets. And one of the targets, Target 9, is focused on invasive species. And it has encouraged countries to actually develop checklists of alien and invasive species to identify them and identify the pathways of their introduction so that they are managed easier. The other key purpose that GRIS would serve is also to develop global indicators on invasive species. These indicators will help us in monitoring the threat better. There are policy indicators and management indicators, so at both ends of the spectrum. It's for policymakers as well as for practitioners. So to come up with a global register of invasive species, it's presented as country checklists. So the GRIS compiler team, which is my team at the Invasive Species Specialist Group, develops draft checklists of species. And it's through literature surveys, through contacting researchers, with at least, I think, about 20 annotations on their taxonomy, then in which biome they occur, whether which pathways entered the country, the dates of introduction, et cetera, impacts, et cetera, and compiles this draft list and sends it to identified experts in all the countries. We have a big network of experts, and the experts actually go through these lists and verify each of the species records. And the result is a verified list of alien and invasive species. When we started developing the GRIS checklist, our goal was to complete the 198 member countries of the Convention on Biological Diversity. This project has been supported by the CBD, actually. In those terms, we would have reached a target of about 80 to 85% of the countries would have been covered by the end of 2018. Additionally, we've also started working on the European Overseas Territories, which number about 54 altogether. I think we would have finished 100% of those territories by then. And we've also done a few autonomous regions for different countries, for example, the Azores and Madeira for Portugal, etc. I'm the deputy chair of information for the Invasive Species Specialist Group. It's one of the specialist groups under the IUCN's Commission on the Species Survival Commission. Now, the IUCN is the largest and one of the oldest environmental networks. And one of the key roles of IUCN is providing knowledge and the tools to private individuals, to the public, to non-governmental organizations, and to the governments to conserve nature better with good information. GBIF, on the other hand, the Global Biodiversity Information Facility, is an international network too, and it's a research infrastructure. Now, the key role of GBIF is to provide common standards and open source tools for data providing institutions so that they can share their data better. IUCN is a gatherer of knowledge, good authoritative knowledge, and GBIF is the platform where this information can be shared. And together, I think we can do wonders in providing good information for decision making and for management. I think having good information gives us the best foundation we can have to develop invasive species indicators. Indicators can be of two types. One is to help policy making, like finding out the trends in introductions, the trends in pathways, and the trends in policy responses from countries to how to manage this threat. And we have indicators for monitoring existing invasions to help practitioners make good management decisions. And having good information and sharing it and adding value by each of the organizations can help us develop these indicators very well, good, reliable ones. A recent meeting in Leipzig explored what we can do together, and there were some indicators which we have been planning to develop. One is on even finding out knowledge gaps, in which parts of the world are there knowledge gaps so that we could, step in and maybe support these countries and institutions. Yeah. That's one example.